Okay, let's just start with no props. Just thinking of our feet. So our toes are pointing forward. I'm gonna just lift the toes up and away from the floor and stretch your toes. Like if you're yawning with your toes and then press them down into the floor, try and lengthen them down. And do that a couple more times. Lift the toes up, try and stretch them, and then press them into the floor. One more time. So no props to start with, Sachna, just leave them by you. We're gonna work with the Dyna band today a little bit more, so keep it by you. We're gonna lift the heels up now, so keep the toes grounded. Lift the heels up a little bit, doesn't have to be much. Push the ceiling away with the crown of the head, and then bring the heels back down. And do that two more times, so breathe it in maybe as you lift the heels up. Push the floor away with your toes, and breathe out, bring it down. One more time, try and relax the arms. Yes, and think of the feet, the toes pushing down, the crown of the head stretching up and stretching your legs, your body. And now keep your feet grounded, put your hands on your ribs. Let's think of the breath a little bit. So as we breathe in, we're breathing, open the ribcage as much as possible, stretch our ribs, our lungs. Exhale through the mouth, squeeze your ribs in, your stomach back, and your pelvic floor. Let's do that again, so breathe in. Through the nose, open the ribs, try and stretch your body, and breathe out through the mouth, squeeze your ribs in, the stomach back, the pelvic floor. One more, breathe in, through the nose, open the ribs, stretch out, maybe hold the breath in, breathing out through the mouth. Remember to make a sound as you breathe out. Okay, just release the arms. You're gonna bring the right arm up, the left arm down as you breathe in. Stretch them away from each other. As you breathe out, cross them in front, and then take the left arm up, stretch it up. Try and lengthen both sides of your body. Exhale on the cross, and keep doing that. Breathing in as you stretch. Breathing out as you cross the arms forward. Breathing in as you stretch. Let's do one last one and keep that right arm up, breathe in. And as you breathe out with the right hand, just grab your head and bring it to a tilt to the right side. Try not to move your shoulders. And then breathe in, come back to center. So you want to really push your shoulders down and don't let your left fingertips ride up your leg. So plug them down, breathe in. I can still see shoulders moving, guys. So plug the fingertips into the thigh and don't let them ride up, those left fingertips. That's better, just ahead. One more like that, breathe in. And as you breathe out, see if you can just hold that side tilt for about 8 seconds and really try and relax the shoulders. Breathe through the left side of your neck. Push the feet down still, lengthen the spine. Now keep breathing out on your next breath out and go into your side bend. So keep going, open the chest up. And as you breathe in, find the length of the spine. So push your hand up with your head, lengthen. And again, exhale, and the head will go down, shoulders, ribs. Try and push the hips forward, especially that right shoulder also. Open the chest, and then breathing in, coming back up. Think of that left arm, Sachna, lengthen it down so it helps find the body's posture. One more, breathing in. So this last one, we're gonna hold it a little bit longer. Push your feet down, especially the left heel, relax the head. Bring the right shoulder forward. See if you can bring the left hand behind the head, interlace your fingers. Open the elbows, stretch your chest forward, your hips forward, try not to sink, better. Now as you breathe in, lengthen, and breathe out, go to the other side. Really try to plug the feet down. And feel the difference of stretching one side and maybe the other not. Breathe in, come back to center, do that again. So breathing out to the side, breathing it as you lengthen, exhaling to the left, plug the right heel down here, nice, breathing it, last one, exhaling, inhale, one more, exhale. Now as you breathe in, stretch the arms up, keep the fingers interlaced, and see if you can find any more length in your body. Try and wriggle up. Really push the feet down, the palms up, and then let go of your fingers, have them facing your palms, and drop the left arm down, the right arm up, and again, feel that length. As you exhale, cross them over, and again, stretch the left arm up, the right arm down. As you exhale, cross again. Use your core just to move the arms, your ribs, your stomach. So you're pushing your stomach back in space as the arms cross on the exhale without losing your height, your posture. Exhale again. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale. Inhale. Can we hold the left arm up now? Grab the head and just stretch it now in a tilt to the left. We try and grab the shoulders down. Notice if you're leaning with your ribs and try and keep your pubic bone and your chest bone in line. And then come back up. Let's do that a few more times. And exhaling, think of your right fingertips sliding down your right leg. Breathe. Just lengthen. Two more. Exhale. Remember to keep the nose pointed forward and don't sink the hips back or the ribs. Exhaling, one more. Let's hold it a little bit longer here and go straight into our side bend. So go with the shoulders, the ribs, the hips. Side bend to the left. Breathing and coming back up. Lovely. Let's do that again. Exhale, first the head. Shoulders, keep pointing your nose forward, pushing the hips forward. The heart forward, breathing again. Looking for a straight spine. Two more. Exhale. Relax that right arm, Sachna. Go on. And pull the head. That's it. Let's do one last one and hold it. When you're ready, exhale into the spine. Hold it there. See if you can bring now the right arm over. Interlace the fingers. Open the chest, the elbows, the hips. Better. See if you can do three exhales here. Two. And a three. Inhale. Come back up. Yeah? The right, exhale, try and go deeper each time and try to avoid sinking. So you want to lengthen as you go into a side bend and not sink back, yeah? Inhale up, keep going, exhale, one. Keep pushing the feet down, opening the chest, the elbows, inhaling, exhaling, one, exhale, two, exhale, three. We'll do one more. Exhaling, one, two, three, hold it there. Open the chest very lightly. Do a little back bend. It's more lifting the chest bone up and looking to where the ceiling and the wall of your room join. So not too far up. As you exhale, club the shoulders down, push the elbows so they point towards the floor and slide your chin down, your head. And do that again. Breathe in. So it's just the head, Sachna. The head, the shoulders a little bit, opening up as you breathe in. And then as you breathe out, dropping the head down, dropping the elbows to point to the floor, plugging the shoulders into our armpits. One more, breathing in. Open the chest. Now as we breathe out, see if we can keep the head down and give it a good stretch. So all the upper body, the neck, try and relax the shoulders. Look at your stomach and on the breath out, push it in with your eyes, with your breath. See if you can go any lower. Keep pushing your feet down, your hips forward. And do one more deep breath there. When you're ready, just release the arms, bend your knees, and start rolling all the way down. So we want to come into our first forward bend. Bend your knees so your stomach is near your thighs, and you can really stretch the hips up as much as possible, keeping your stomach near your thighs. Relax the head. If you can just say yes 8 times with your chin towards your chest, and bounce it back naturally. 4 more little knots, and 3, and 2, and 1. Breathe in, stop the head movement, just release the head. As you breathe out, we're rolling back up one vertebra at a time. Head is the last thing to come up. So take your time, squeeze your stomach in, and find a straight spine. Let's do that again. So breathing in, just to lengthen the spine. You see, in the way of the crown of the head. Breathe out, let go of the head, then the shoulders. Squeeze your stomach in, release the arms. Roll your way down, use your pelvic floor. Try to stretch your hips up, but try and keep your stomach near your thighs. And then we're gonna say no with our head. So try and unscrew your head from your shoulders, saying no, chin to right shoulder, bend to left. Crown of the head always points towards the floor. We'll do 4 more. 3, 2, 1. Release the head so it hangs, breathe in, breathe out, squeeze your stomach in, make your core, build up your spine again, one vertebra at a time. Relax the shoulders. Okay, can we do one with maybe with our head now upside down? When you're ready, breathe in. So breathe out and drop the head. See if you can go any deeper. Make your way down on the exhale. Remember to squeeze your pelvic floor. It will help you stretch also and strengthen. When you're ready, swing the head so that right ear goes to the right shoulder, then to the left, and you're swinging your head like a pendulum, upside down with your crown pointed towards the earth and your coccyx up towards the ceiling. Two more sways, one more sway, then releasing the head, letting it hang, and rolling up one vertebra at a time. Here's the last thing to come up. Lovely. I would like to work with the Dyna band a little bit now. So grab your Dyna band and remember you can do it without a Dyna band, especially the Dyna band. Sometimes it's better to have a soft one or a hard one depending on the exercise. So if you have a couple, you can change or take it away. Let's just grab the Dyna band. So you're grabbing about shoulder distance and we're going to stretch the arms up. So just make sure there's a little bit of tension in the Dyna band and just stretch the arms up as you breathe in. That's it, both arms up. And as you breathe out, bring it back down and just find a little bit of tension so the tricep works. This muscle here you should feel as you pull out. Yeah, so you're breathing in, lifting up, opening the chest, pulling out just a little bit, no, not too much tension, just slightly exhaling back down. Let's do that again, two more. Try and keep the elbows and the wrists, remember, really straight. Exhaling and on the way down. No angles, better, and that's it. Breathing in, let's keep the arms up now. Try and see if you can lift and then drop the shoulders down, shoulder blade action. So breathe in, lift, breathe out, drop down. Breathe in, breathe out, yeah? In and out. Two more of you. And out, shoulders up, shoulders down, keep them down. So a little bit broader with the Dyna band, a little bit broader. And see if you can just bend your elbows and just pull, tug a little bit the Dyna band. That's it, inhale, stretch again, yeah? Exhaling, very lightly, push the elbows back, open the chest. Breathing in and try not to flex the wrists, so there should be straight lines. Exhaling, the only bending is your elbows, ideally. Inhale, go a little bit faster, 8, inhale, 7, inhale, 6, we'll leave you there, inhale, open the hands a little bit more, Sachna, try and get them right over your elbows, one more, good, can we just stretch the arms now so that the Dyna band is like a scarf around our neck, or our shoulders. And what you want to do is grab the Dyna band as it's most comfortable to you with your hands and stretch your shoulder blades away from each other so that you're pulling on the Dyna band, shoulder blades away and shoulder blades towards. So you're actually feeling the Dyna band stretch and then shorten. Yeah? And stretch and shorten. We'll do four more. Stretch and shorten for four. Stretch and shorten for three, and shorten for two, one more, and shorten for one. Well done. Try and keep your arms up and just stretch them forward. Maybe lengthen a little bit more the Dyna band. And what you want to do is the same movement. So stretch your shoulder blades away from each other and then towards. Arms a little bit high. It should be your bra strap. That's a good place to put it, the Dyna. And exhale back. One more slowly. Shoulder blades forward and then back. A little bit faster, forward and back. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. One more, breathe in, breathe out. And release, well done, just shift the shoulders. Okay, last one, just to open the chest and wake up our back. We're doing our chest opener, back strengthening. Try and see how much you need to hold to feel a little bit that you can open. And if your Dyna band is a hard one, give yourself a good stretch there, so a good space. So you're going to breathe in here, and as we breathe out, push the elbows in and the Dyna band back. And again, breathing in, forward. Exhaling. Breathing in. Exhaling. Nice. Do a little bit faster, so breathe in, breathe out. 8, breathe out. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Try and keep those elbows in and that hands out and do little bounces back. That's it, squeeze the elbows in. 8 more, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Well done, release and shake through the shoulders. I'd like to try a forward bend now, engaging the core and using our Ayora band. Just lastly, try and see if you can stretch both legs, both feet on the Ayora band, and just stretch it up so that you're holding it and you feel your Ayora band helping your shoulders plug down. Let's start with the beginning of this movement. So you want to squeeze your stomach in, your arms back, slightly bend them so the elbows slightly hug in and the head drops. And you're using your core, yeah? And breathing in, you're looking forward and releasing. Try to do that a couple of times. So exhale, squeeze your hips forward, your ribs and shoulders down. Breathing in, looking forward. And again, exhaling. Inhaling. One more like that, then we'll go a little bit deeper. So exhale, stomach in, look at your stomach, push it in with your eyes. Breathing in, come back to center. See, we can go into a forward bend now. So you're gonna move it to breathe out. Start like that, and then start bending your knees. You can roll all the way down and really stretch the arms up. One day your elbows will stretch. Hold it there, breathe in. As you breathe out, roll back up. Bend your elbows a little bit, your knees. Use your core. That is the last thing to come up. Lovely. Can you do that two more times? Breathe in. To breathe out, first the head, the shoulders, squeeze your stomach back, bend your knees, roll down and use your core, and stretch your arms up towards the ceiling. Breathe in, breathing out, rolling up. It's the last thing to come up, so take your time, relax the shoulders. Okay, this last one, just so you can see, we're going to be upside down and try and go deeper each time. 8 times, exhaling, try and use your core. Relax the head. So here we go. Breathing in, just lengthen your spine. As you breathe out, it's the head, shoulders, ribs, hips. Find your forward stretch. When you stretch those arms up, the head down, and start doing little bounces. Squeeze your stomach in as you exhale for 1, exhale 2, exhale 3, exhale 4 more. 3, 2, 1. And then slowly breathe in, and as you exhale, release and come back up to a standing position. Okay, well done. Let's finish off with a few balances and a Ayora band. So you want your Ayora band, whoops, around your right foot. And try and grab it so that your thumbs are up. Try and squeeze your elbows in. And really don't use your arms to lift your leg, remember? So you're gonna breathe in, lift the leg up. I don't usually do, try not to use the arms too much. Breathe out, push it down. And we'll do that a couple of times. So you're gonna breathe in, lift the leg up. Try and lengthen. Exhale down. 2 more. Exhale. Last one, we're holding the leg up. And see if you can stretch the leg forward as you breathe out and breathe in, bring it back. So we've got 3 more. Exhale. In. Lovely. 2 more. Exhale. Squeeze those elbows in. Try and find length. Last one. Exhale. Just hold it there. See if you can just hold and find length for 8 seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4. Lift it up a little bit more, maybe. And then release. Let's try the other leg. I've got a little bit of a bad knee, so I might give up if I feel that it's a little bit painful. So I'm testing my leg today. I woke up with a bit of an inflamed knee. It happens as I get older. I walked a little bit too much, I think. Well, let's go for it. Okay, we've got the left foot, right, with the Ayora band. You're lifting it up. That's it. And exhale, push it back down. And let's do that. Exhaling as you push the leg down. So it's different to how we usually do it. With the Dyna band, you want to push down on the exhale. Use your core for the resistance of the Dyna band. Now you're gonna breathe in and lift up to stay up. Find that position. As you exhale now, stretch. Lovely. Inhale, bend. Find the length of the spine. Do it three more times. Exhale. And inhale. Try to really drop that left hip down and squeeze your elbows in. Let them lengthen your spine, the sides of your waist. One more. Exhale it. See if you can hold it there. 8 seconds. Squeeze your inner thighs and lengthen out of your hips. 4 more seconds. 3, 2. Lift it a little bit more, maybe. And then drop it down. Well done. Your legs are shake. And we're going to go to the mat. Keep your Dyna band nearby. And just roll down from the back of our mat forward like we usually do, but with no props today. So remember to move your camera. We're going to stay in the mat now. I think I need to start thinking of putting the air conditioning on. It's really, really hot here now. Summer's here soon. It's June, right? Or is it May when it starts? Anyway, it must be soon. I can feel it. Summer vibes. Okay, well, at the back of the mat, right? We're going to breathe in. As we breathe out, start rolling down. Relax the head. Make sure you use your core and really curl into that stretch and hold it a little bit longer. You can just do little movements, circular movements with your head, pointing the crown of your head towards the floor and just letting it go. And then go the other way, change direction. Or in little circles with the crown of the head. And then stop there, hold your opposite arms, your opposite elbows, and start doing little circles with your ribs. Try to isolate just the movement of your ribs as you do those circles. And then change direction. So opposite way, try and isolate the rib cage. Try to stay there a little bit longer, guys. Leave your hands on the floor and now do little circles with your hips. So try not to move your ribs now. Try the other way, change direction, circle with the hips the other way. We're nearly there. When you're ready, walk forward with your hands, find a plank position, and try and hold here the length of your body, pushing your chest bone away from the floor. Remember not to let the head drop. Try and keep the hips, that's it, belly down, in line with your shoulders, and hug the stomach back, those lower ribs, a little bit more. 4 more seconds there, go on. 3, 2, and 1. Drop the knees down. Let's go into cat-cow. So you're gonna breathe in as you look up, open the chest. Breathing out, curl the spine, push the floor away. And again, breathing in, looking up, opening the chest. Breathing out, curling the spine. One more, breathing in. Breathing out, curling the spine. See if you can now push your toes into the floor, lift your hips up, and come into a downward dog with bent knees. Hold it though, and do 8 little bounces back with the chest, trying to lift the hips as high as possible. Try to push your rib cage towards your thighs. Lift your tailbone up, 4 more little bounces there. 3, 2, 1, and then release down. Come into a child's pose, so sit your hips back, walk your hands forward. Relax the head down. And as you do this position, try and really stretch your breath, stretch your ribs, your spine, as you breathe in, and remember to hold a couple of seconds of breath in. And then as you breathe out, stretch your breath out, squeeze your core, and hold a couple of seconds, the breath out, the pelvic floor. One more deep breath there. Okay, great. Can we bring our right knee and our right foot forward? So we're in a box lunge. I'm going to mirror you. So we're not too deep into a lunge, and we're trying to get our hands on the floor, maybe our fingers or our fists. I like to work my fists on the floor. And what I'd like us to explore here is a cat-cow. So you want to try and breathe in and push your tailbone back and open your chest. And as you breathe out, see if you can really curl your spine, squeeze your inner thighs, and push your forehead near your knee. Push the floor away with your arms like you would in a cat-cow. That's it, and plug the shoulders down, away from your ears, even more. Better. Now, breathe in, look up. You're stretching your hamstring here, open the chest. And then exhaling, curling the spine. Pull head to knee as much as your body allows. Plug the shoulders down, push the floor away. Squeeze your pelvic floor, your stomach in. Stretch that elbow, that's it. One more, breathe in. Open the chest. And breathing out. Pull head to knee. Okay, now we want to find a position where we're not curling the spine or overstretching it, arching it. You want to try and find as much length as possible. You might need books, and I might have told you that, but try and keep your fingers on the floor and lengthen here. I just want us to explore now, lifting the right hip up and then down. Just a couple of times, lift it up and away from the floor and back down, yeah? And keep that right big toe on the floor. Don't let it lift. And if your knee hurts, let me know and I'll give you an option. Okay, now see if you can keep still your hands on the floor and do little circles to the right with your hips. So we're going to do four circles to the right. That's it. Three, two, one. And then stop there. Four circles with the right arm reaching up and away from the right hip that reaches down. Look at the arm, reach it up, draw a circle with it. Exhale in, drop it back down, and look at it go and brush the floor. And again, breathe in, lift the arm up, push that right hip down towards the floor. Exhale in, drop it back down. Two more, breathe in. Breathe in out. One more, breathe in. Really try and reach up, guys. Try and push the floor away with your left arm. So stretch your left elbow. Turn your nipples towards the right side of the room. That's it, better. Reach up. Right palm faces the right side of the room. Now squeeze your inner thighs. Push your right hip back and down. Just hold it there. Hold it there. Lengthen the spine. Four more seconds. Three, two, one, and then drop down. Well done. Sit back. Can you sit back with both knees on the floor? Please let me know your knees hurt. Mine hurt. Maybe that's why I'm asking. But this is good for them. This doesn't hurt them. So let me know who is good. I'd like to do a child's pose and walk our hands this time towards the right side of the mat. So sit your hips back. Maybe shift your weight to your left heel a little bit. And really deep there. Too deep. When you're ready, come back to center. And we'll go to the other side. So the same sequence, but now with the left leg forward. Little things I could see is that maybe possible, bring that heel right under your knee. For some of you, it was a little bit further back, which isn't too good for the knee. So make sure that your left heel lands right under your knee, okay? And just explore where your arms want to be. Fists, palms, fingertips. And start doing your cat-cow. So you're going to breathe in, open the chest, look up. And breathe out, curl. Push your chin towards your pubic bone. Plug the shoulders down, better, and stretch your elbows as much as you can. Push the floor away. And again, breathe in. Breathe in out. Plug in the left big toe into the floor too. Squeeze your inner thigh. One more, breathe in. Breathe out. Good. Now stretch your spine. Look at a neutral spine position and see if you can just lift the left hip up and down four times. Up towards the ceiling and down towards the floor. Up towards the ceiling and down towards the floor. Up. One more time and up. Now the idea is to keep it down.
But first, do little circles with your hips to the left. So 8 little circles, 7. Try not to move anything else. Squeeze your inner thighs. 4 more, 3, 2, 1. Good, plug that left hip down. Squeeze your inner thigh still. Keep everything square in the hip. Start drawing circles with your left arm forward, all the way up. It's a twist, guy. We haven't twisted yet. So twist your nipples to the side and then drop down. Follow the arm with your eyes. Breathing in as you lift and drop. Exhaling. Breathing in. Breathing out. One more. Can we reach up with the arm and stay there? 8 seconds. Slide the shoulders away from your ears. Reach up and hold it, guys. Squeeze your inner thighs. Don't let the hips move. Push that left hip down and a little bit more. Go on. Ah! And now you can twist a little bit more. Squeeze that inner thigh though. 4, 3, 2, 1. Release. Well done. Much better. Sit back. Child's pose. Then we walk ourselves to the left with our arms in the child's pose. Relax the hip. Breathe deeply. So you're giving the right side of your waist, your spine especially, a good stretch here, your right lung. So take the attention to that space and breathe through that space. As if the pores of your skin could inhale and exhale, that's the feeling. One more deep breath, remember to pause. Coming back to center. We'll sit up and grab our Dyna Bands again. I haven't forgotten, told you. And we'll work with our Dyna Bands now. Around our legs, we'll do a little bit of core work, okay? So just wrap your Dyna Band around your feet. Remember that it's better to flex the toes so that the Dyna Band doesn't escape. And remember to squeeze your elbows and keep really stiff wrists. No bending, no handbag, wrist. That's it. So using the breath in to lengthen the spine. As you breathe out, roll back like we usually do, but with the help of the Dyna Band, push your pubic bone up, stomach in, inner thighs, and then breathing in, come back up. Let's do that again. Exhaling, curl the hips, stomach in, C-shaped position with your spine. Your feet are together, squeeze your inner thighs. Breathing in, lengthen again. Your knees are together. And again, exhale, roll back. Moving from the lumbar spine first. Relax the shoulders though. Oh, yes, breathing in. Stretching up. 2 more. Thinking of relaxing the shoulders and really squeezing your stomach in, your tailbone up. Better. Breathing in. 1, breathe in, 1, breathe in, coming back up. I'd like to try and go forward, so I like to grab right at the end of my Dyna Band for this, so not like it is easy. If you want to try and stretch your arms from this position, you can open them up, but try and squeeze them back to this position. Try not to bend your elbows and keep them wide, yes, better. Breathing in, bend them, and sit back up. Lengthen the spine. Can we try that again? Exhale, head forward, squeeze your core, stretch your arms back, go on, find it, stretch your arms. And then inhale. And again, exhale. Susan, that yellow one is really hard, so don't stretch your arms, but squeeze your elbows in. Breathing in. Exhaling, going back. That's better. Shoulders down, guys. Shoulders down. Breathing in. Can we do one more? Just hold it down and do little pulses down, trying to go deeper as you exhale. So breathe in here, and as you breathe out, roll down, squeeze the stomach in, and then shoulders down and exhale. 1 deeper. And 2. Arms up, head down. Arms up and head down. For 4. And for 3. And a 2, and a 1. Well done. Breathe in, stretch up. Relax the shoulders. If you want to roll all the way down, make sure you've got space too. So as you breathe out, take your time, use the Dyna Band, squeeze the elbows still. but two foot forward, down to the floor, one vertebra at a time. Good. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, see if you can roll back up. So start with your head and shoulders, and if that's enough, that might be as far as you go. If you can go a little bit deeper, try it out. At the top of the movement, you want to breathe in. As you breathe out, you want to roll back down, exhaling slowly. We'll try that one more time. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe in out. Rolling all the way down and staying down. So take the dynaband away from your feet and see if you can think of a tabletop position. Keep the dynaband nearby, but bring your hands by your hips on the floor. We're going to start simple. I want you to think of this. Your stomach goes in and then the leg lifts to a tabletop and your shin is parallel to the floor like a table. But stomach in and then the leg goes up. Really try and work the core, work the leg. So you're going to just lift the right leg up on an exhale. Inhale, drop it down. Then work the left leg up, exhale, tabletop position. Inhale, down. The hard part is to go stomach in, leg up, exhale. Inhale, down. So try, stomach in, leg up. Make the work come from the core. Inhale, down. Let's do four more. Exhale, stomach in, leg up. Ribs in also. It's not about flaring the ribs, so hug them in. Stomach in, ribs in, leg up. Inhale. And without shortening the spine, keep going. One last one, and we're gonna change the pattern of the movement. So you're gonna lift the right leg up, exhale it up. Exhale the left leg up. Go for a tabletop. Inhale, right leg down. Inhale, left leg down, yes? Exhale, right leg up. And left leg, exhale. Inhale, right leg. Inhale, left. Let's go a little bit faster. So exhale up, inhale, right down, inhale, left. Right up, right down, left down. Right and a left and a right. Let's start with left. Exhale, left, then the right. Down with left, then a right. Exhale, try not to collapse on the legs, arrive to the floor, it's soft. Exhale, stomach, exhale, and down. One more, exhale, one, and a two, and a down, good. Can we now imagine that the floor is hot? We don't want to burn our feet, so we're on our toes. On our big toes. We're going to try and push the floor away with our hands, with our shoulders open, and exhale both legs up. Keep that 90 degree angle, right? You're going to touch your toes to the floor, and then exhale back up again. And we're just doing four, but we're doing it properly. Squeeze your inner thighs, breathe in, drop. Exhale, stomach in, legs up, that's one. Breathe in, drop. Exhale, stomach in, legs up, that's two. Two more, breathe in. Shoulders on the floor, keep them broad, exhale. Last one, breathe in. And exhaling, well done. Squeeze the knees towards your chest, give them a hug. Just your head and shoulders if that feels good to really get a good grip. And what I want you to do is now decide, I've moved my mic so it's a little bit closer, so you can hear me. If your groins hurt, sometimes groins are delicate depending what you've done. You might want to put your feet on a chair or on a wall and do your tabletop position supported by that. Because I'm going to do my favorite exercise now. It's targeting the core, and I'm sure you know which one it is, but your groin mustn't hurt. So we're going to keep a tabletop position, maybe with a chair underneath or any kind of support. Your neutral pelvis, so you're not arching and you're not crunching, you're supporting your spine. Your dynaband is on your shins like a table, and you're going to grab the top of it. Squeeze your inner thighs. Keep your head down for the moment and use your core to move your arms now. So you're gonna exhale, Squeeze the diner band with your hands and pull it down. Keep stretched arms. Breathe in, let go. The legs shouldn't move. Exhale, down. Squeeze your inner thighs, pelvic floor. Inhale, let go. Exhale. Try not to let your hips change. Breathe in, let go. Exhale. And see if we can lift our head and shoulders as an option. So now as you pull the diner band down, head and shoulders lift as an option. And then inhale, you drop. Now I'd like to do five more. Exhale, lift. Whatever version you want. Inhale, drop. Exhale, four. Inhale, drop. Exhale, three. Good. Just two more, guys. Exhale, two. Last one, you can keep your head up or down. We're gonna do the 100 with the diner band, and that's it. We'll have a break. Go on. 8 seconds. Breathing in, two, three, four, five, breathe out. Two, three, four, five, breathe in. Two, three, four, five, breathe out. One more, two, three, four, five, breathe out. Two, three, four, and five. Well done. Release the legs, squeeze them to your chest. Give them a hug, but keep your hold of the diner band for a second. Because we're gonna switch leg lifts using the diner band in our core. So what you want is to plug the left foot into the floor and catch your right foot with your diner band. If the groin hurts, then you bend your knee. But if you can, keep that right leg stretched. Grab the diner band, squeeze your elbows in, breathe in the chest, and you're gonna just drop the leg down. And as you breathe out, stomach in, then your leg will go up. Yeah, remember that. Inhale, down. Exhale, working from the core, stomach in, leg up. Ribs in also. Breathing into drop. Exhale, back up. So we're doing five more. Keep going to the rhythm of your breath. And remember that you shouldn't be moving your left knee. You shouldn't be wobbling around. So really try and keep it, whoo, try and keep it still. These diner bands are dangerous sometimes, aren't they? I think that means I need to buy a new one. It's been out in the sun. I've been doing a lot of classes in the sun because it's been nice weather now. Exhale up. Do one more and let's keep the leg up. So once it's up, you want to try and isolate the movement of your toes and your ankle. You can keep them bent or not. But see if you can do little circles with your right toes, your right ankle. And do four more. Three. Try and relax the shoulders. Two. Can we go the other way? So eight little circles to the left or change your direction. Remember that the knee shouldn't move, even if it's bent. Keep it still. Four, three, two, and one. Now see if you can bend and stretch the knee. So you're gonna bend it towards your chest. And then as you breathe out, try and exhale it. When you stretch the leg, keeping the hips on the floor. And again, breathe in, let it bend. Exhale, stomach in, bend, stretch the leg. Good, inhale and bend. Exhale, so your core is there to plug the hips into the floor, keeping a neutral pelvis. Breathing in. Breathing out, stretching the leg. Can we keep the leg stretched in the next one? So as you breathe out, keep your leg stretched. And see if you can turn the leg out like Charlie Chaplin and then back to center. So you're turning the whole leg out from the hip joint and then back to center. Yeah? Pull the leg out and then back to center. Now turn the leg out, keep turning out the leg and see if you can let the leg drop into a straddle kick without the other knee moving at all. As you breathe out, lead with your heel, squeeze your inner thighs, your pelvic floor, and come back up. Still in Charlie Chaplin. We'll do three more. So you're gonna breathe in as you drop and breathe out as you squeeze your inner thighs and come back to center. Lead with the heel. Nice. Two last ones. Breathing in. Breathing out. One more. Breathing in. And as you breathe out, come back to center. And what I want to do is combine those two movements, a kick and a straddle drop. So you're going to start with what we've just begun with, turning the leg out and letting it drop to the side. Then letting it continue to the bottom of the mat, bring it to parallel and kick it up. So you want to turn it out, drop it to the side, then let it continue to the bottom of the mat. Exhale, lift it up, parallel. Two more like that, turn it out. Good. Drop, exhale. Drawing circle, one more circle. And then we'll change the direction of those circles. So you're gonna reverse that. You're gonna kick down, turn the leg out through a straddle, and then exhale up. That's it, good touch now. Kick down, turn the leg out. Good. Notice the opposite knee though. Is it winging out? Try and avoid that. Keep the foot grounded. One last one. And we'll hold the leg up and give it a bit of a stretch here before we go to the other side. So see, you can just try and walk up your diamond with your hand or your leg. Grab as high as you can and stretch your right leg towards your body, towards the floor. And relax the shoulders. Maybe stretch the bottom leg, the left leg, onto the floor, really trying to push it down if you are. And that should help also the other leg stretch up. Do one deep breath there. Now see if you can grab your Dyna band with the left hand. And just let the right hand drop, or you can bring it to your hip and cross that right leg over to the left side of your mat. But not enough for the hips to move. The hips are still on the floor. Remember that one? Really push that right hip down and into the floor. Hold it there, try and stretch the knee a little bit more, the thigh. Better. And see if you can cross now all the way. You can bend the knee, but cross your right leg all the way to the left side of your mat and find a twist there. See if you can look towards the right hand. So you're twisting your neck, you're stretching your neck. Keep your chest open. If you can stretch your leg, try and stretch it. And imagine you're pushing the walls of your house away with your arms, with your leg. One more deep breath there. See how much of a twist you can get. Good. Use your breath. Drop that right hip down towards the bottom of your mat, away from your armpit, Anne. Yeah, and then coming back up when you're ready. Give that leg a hug. And we'll do just to release the groin area and make sure you let me know if it does hurt. That's the groin. We'll go to the other side if you're ready. So plug the right foot into the floor. Remember, it's right under the knee. And you're going to work catching your left foot, your left leg. So keep your elbows in. Try and relax the shoulders and start those kicks. So you're breathing in, kicking down in parallel. Breathing out, stomach in, then the leg up. Use your core. It's a core exercise, right? Breathe in as you drop down. Breathe out, stomach in, leg up. And you could lift your head and shoulders, Susan, if that's what you want to do. That's also an option to work the core even more. Keep going, guys. But four more. Exhaling up. Try not to move the opposite knee at all. Don't let it wobble. Exhale up. Two last ones. Exhale up. One more. Keep the leg up. And start little circles with your toes, your ankle. So you're gonna do about eight. And try and really move the whole ankle, the toes. And do as perfect circle as you can. And then change directions, other way. So you're stretching the foot, working your calf here. Relax the shoulders though. Notice if your head's leaning to one side, remember that your nose should point towards the ceiling. Okay, stop that movement of the ankle and let's move the knee. So you're gonna bend it and then stretch it as you exhale, as much as you can. And again, bend the knee, breathe in. Breathing out, stomach in, leg up. And breathing in, breathing out. Keep going, we've got three more. Keep working the left hip away from your armpit, especially if the left leg stretches. It will want to come up. And keep it on the floor. Exhale, stretch the leg. One more. And we'll keep our legs stretched. That's the left leg. And start doing a Charlie Chaplin position. Turn the leg out, whole leg, in the hip socket. And then back to parallel. And again, exhale as you turn it. Inhale, back to parallel. Exhale, turn it out. Inhale, one last one. So now you want to turn the leg out, keep it turned out, and drop into that straddle kick down to the side. And I've really moved everything, so you're not meant to do that. Exhale, back up. So that left knee, remember, you pretend you're carrying and keep going. Drop the leg down, lead with the toes, remember, you're turning out. And then lead with the heel as you exhale up. Don't let the leg turn in. Two more. So I was going to say, you're pretending there's a cup of tea on your left knee, or your right knee, better said, and you don't want to spill it. One last one. Breathe in. Good. And breathe out. Let's start the kicks. So you're going to do four kicks, starting in the straddle, then going to the bottom of the mat, and then parallel kick up. That's one. Turn out, straddle, lower down, exhale up, stomach in, leg up, that's two. Turn out, then lower, you're going to get more movement out of the hip, then parallel, exhale up. Last one, breathing in, I promise. That's better. Let's go the other way. So kick down first, parallel. Turn out, let me see you turn out, go on. Better, and back up. Again, parallel kick down. Inhale still as you turn out to the side. Now, squeeze your inner thighs as you kick up. Two more, nice, go on Sachna, two more. We're there, and it's looking nice. One more. Great. Stop at the top here. Walk your way up your Dyna band, maybe your head and shoulders lift. Give yourself a good tug here. Drop the head back down, relax the shoulders. Maybe stretch the right leg into the floor and pull the left leg towards you, especially on the breath out. Try and keep your wrist as strong as possible, Lan. Lovely. One more little pull before we let it go. Now, the left hand, I like to put it on my left hip. It's the same as those knee things we were doing on our knees, lifting the hip and dropping in the warm-up from the floor. Try and push that hip down, the left hip down, away from the armpit, and grab with your right hand your Dyna band and cross the leg as much as your hips don't lift off the floor to start with. So you're really getting into the lumbar spine, the hips, the back of the knee. Try and stretch the leg, push the sides of your room away. And now see if you can bend the knee, maybe, or keep it stretched, but go into a full side bend, side twist here. So you're looking towards the left side, twisting towards the right. Keep going, breathing in. Use your ribs to twist and do one more. Deep breath there. Squeezing your inner thighs, your pelvic floor. Good. Come back to center when you're ready. Let the Dyna band go and squeeze the legs in. Again, this time you can really hug them in, so get a good grip and then do three breaths where you're trying to really compress your legs into your body as you breathe out, and then release them a little bit as you breathe in. Like if you were squeezing a sponge. Again, squeeze your legs in. And then release. One. Exhale, squeeze in. Inhale, release. Okay, nice. Plug the feet into the floor and wrap your Dyna band around your legs. We're gonna open our chest just to finish off with a bridge. So your Dyna band wants to be tight so that you feel the tension in it and make sure that it doesn't undo.
You want your feet hip distance apart, right under your knees. Going into bridges. I'd like to do to finish five bridges. Curl in on our way up and using the core. So when you're ready, make sure that the Dynaband and is on your thighs. Unless it's uncomfortable there, yeah? And that it's not too tight. Okay, let's go, guys. Breathe in, and as you breathe out, you know your bridge, so you're gonna curl from the core first, then push your feet down and lift all the way up. Your hips, your chest towards the ceiling. Inhale at the top. As you breathe out, see if you can curl back down. One vertebra at a time. Good. Let's do four more. Let me see it. Breathing in. To breathe out, curl in the tailbone off the floor. Use your core and then lifting up. Use the back of the leg, the arms. Lift the chest, Susan. Go on. Lift up. Breathe in. Breathing out. Hugging the chest down, then the middle spine, lower spine. Breathing in. To breathe out and curl up again. Satchana, remember that movement that comes from the core first. So take a little bit longer to come up. Breathe in. Breathing out. Rolling down. So you really want to focus on the core, lifting your tailbone off the floor. Nice and breathe in. To breathe out. Core. And then push the feet down. Remember, we were talking about that one class together. Breathing in at the top. To breathe out and peel your way down. Last one, breathe in, nice. Breathing out, to stay up this time. See if you can walk your feet any further back, Susan. Lift your hips anymore, your chest, your shoulders closer. Nice, Sachna. Now see if you can open your knees a little bit and close them. Open and close, keep your hips high. We're doing eight, exhaling out, and eight, and seven, and six, and three. And two, and one. Breathe in, lift a little bit higher if you can. And breathing out, rolling down, one vertebra at a time. Grab the legs, take the Dynaband away, and just hug them in, but this time just rock side to side. So massaging your lumbar spine. And when you're ready, just roll your way up to a sitting position. Any comfortable sitting position where our spine is stretched, and take a moment to stretch your neck. So interlace your fingers and just press your chin down, your head down. Remember that your chin is in line with your chest and your pubic bone. Don't let your chest sink back. And just stretch the back of your neck here. Breathe in deeply a couple of times, moving the head, seeing where there's tender spots, and breathing into them. Give yourselves about 20 more seconds here. Now looking forward and then up, interlacing the fingers to wriggle up and find a little bit of space or more space in our spine. Breathing as you do that. And as you breathe out, slide the shoulders down, the ribs in, the stomach back, arms together. Okay, nice. Hope that was okay for you.